Hello friends, my name is Shikha and today we are going to perform some informal introduction to Python. In previous session we have learnt about how to install Python on your Windows machine और आज के session में हम देखने वाले हैं कि हम Python interpreter को as a calculator कैसे use कर सकते हैं और हम कुछ strings के साथ manipulations भी करके देखेंगे. So let's start with using Python as a calculator. We perform some mathematical operations on simple calculator in our daily life. Same mathematical operations can be done on Python screen as well. And the interpreter will act as a simple calculator and it will provide you the output of those mathematical operations. So let's see some examples of it. This is the Python screen. We have installed Python on previous session. And here, if you want to do some addition on two integers, suppose I am performing addition operations on 2 plus 2 on, this is called a command prompt of Python. So on the prompt I am performing addition operation, and when I will press an enter, Python interpreter will provide me the output of it. In similar way, if you want to perform some complex programming, complex expressions, then it will provide you the output of those as well. Now mathematics में हमें ये पता होता है कि सबसे पहले जब भी हम कोई expression लिखते हैं तो उसमें पहले divide होता है, उसके बाद multiplication होता है, उसके बाद plus होता है और उसके बाद minus होता है. और अगर हमें पहले minus और plus करना हो और बाद में multiplication करना हो तो हम उसे parenthesis के अंदर रखते हैं. Same can be done in Python as well. You can group your expression and you can perform the complex programming, complex command execution. In this previous command, we have seen that first the mathematical operation will perform multiplication and then it will subtract that output from number 50. Now here, if I am grouping this number, then first the subtraction will be done and then the output will be multiplied to number 6. And by pressing enter, you will see the different result of it. So in this way, you can group your expression as well in Python. You can perform a division as well. Now, what are called plus, minus, multiplication, divide, parenthesis? These are all called operators. And 2, 4, 6, 8, these are called integers. And 1.333, this is called a floating number. Now, what are all these? We are going to learn about these in our next session. Here, we are just learning some basic things that we can do in Python. So, अब आप इधर एक छोटा सा डिफरेंस देखेंगे कि जब भी आप प्लस माइनस मल्टीप्लिकेशन करेंगे तो आप देखेंगे कि हमेशा आउटपुट आपको आईएनटी फॉर्म में ही मिलेगा. जब अगर आप आईएनटी दे रहे हैं तो आपको इंट फॉर्म में ही आपको उसका आउटपुट मिलेगा, और अगर आप फ्लोट दे रहे हैं, फ्लोटिंग नंबर दे रहे हैं, तो आपको उसका आउटपुट फ्लोट में ही मिलेगा. लेकिन जब भी आप कभी कोई डिवीजन ऑपरेटर देंगे तो आपको उसका आउटपुट हमेशा फ्लोट में मिलेगा, क्योंकि डिवीजन हमेशा ज़रूरी नहीं है कि number should be divisible with the given number. So it will provide you the output in floating form. So if you want to say that you don't want the floating point, then you can use double slash operator instead of single divide. And to see the remainder part, you can use modulus operator and it will provide you the remainder part. So what are all these operators? We are going to see that in our next session. We can, here we have only seen that we can use Python interpreter as a calculator as well. So if you want to assign any value to any variable, you can assign that value directly to the prompt and you won't need any data type to it. Assign it. The variable will take default data type according to the value assigned to it. So in this way, various mathematical operations can be done on Python screen. So let's see an the Python interpreter acts as a simple calculator, and you can type an expression at it and it will write the value. And the expression syntax is straightforward, and the operators plus, minus, multiplication and divide are used just like any other languages and for grouping too. So we have seen some examples of it. Now next, let's move to strings. Now, how would you represent a string in Python prompt? You can do it by using single quote or double quotes. Single quote, both will provide you the same output. Let's see some example. Here, you are seeing an example of a single quote string. And similarly, you are seeing the example of a double quote string. In this way, you can represent strings on your Python screen as well. And if you want any operator to be present in your string, and it since your Python is already knows the meaning of all the operators, so if you use any operator within a string, it will provide you the different output. Let's see some example of it. If I want to write apostrophe within a single quote, then Python will provide me an invalid syntax. Here, Python interpreter पहली वाली जो पहला वाला जो single quote है उसके लिए पहला वाला ही enclosed single quote को interpret करेगा और दूसरे वाले के लिए हमें error दे देगा. But हम चाहते हैं कि हमारा जो output हो वो इसी format में आए, तो उसके लिए हम क्या कर सकते हैं? उसके लिए either you use isn't in single quote, double quote, sorry, and it will provide you the same output, or you can use a escape character within a single quote, then it will provide you the same output. Now, what is this escape character and what are all the uses of it? We are going to learn that in our upcoming sessions. So here, in this manner, you can represent your string on Python screen. So, in today's session, we have learned about how to use Python as a calculator, and we can represent a string to it to Python, and then we can directly assign any value to the variable on Python prompt. So, this is for today's session. For next session, we are going to provide you some more information on Python. Till then, thank you and goodbye.